Bells have an inherently minor sound. Embedded in that single bell is an entire minor chord, and I've talked about that. So you'd think that it would just not be a good idea to play anything in a major key on bells. But actually, there are ways to play major chords on bells that minimize the clashing between major and minor. To figure out how, we need to consider two things: register and voicing. Let's start with register. Register is how high or low in pitch we're playing, essentially determined by the size of the bells. On the carillon, a low register means we're playing the bass bells in the lowest octave, and a high register means we're playing the treble bells all the way up here. So let's compare registers. Here's a C major chord in the low register on the bass bells. Now compare that to a C major chord in the high register on the treble bells. Notice how in that high register, a major chord sounds much brighter and happier than in the bass bells? That's because that minor third overtone that really dominates the sound of a bell is much more present in bigger, deeper bells. Look, I'll show you. Here's a frequency analysis of that low C bell. That first peak is the hum tone, a C, and the second is the prime. That's the note we predominantly hear, also a C. Then that third peak, that's the minor third, E flat. Notice the amplitude on that minor third. It's even louder than the hum tone or the prime, and it persists throughout the decay of the sound. So the amplitude and duration of this E flat overtone is going to mean that this bell, this C bell, sounds very minor, and if we use the bell to play a major chord, we're going to get a clash between major and minor. Now, let's run the same frequency analysis on a C bell three octaves higher. There's our hum tone, our prime, and the minor third. But notice that minor third is a bit smaller, and it dissipates a lot faster. So the minor third in this C bell isn't as dominant, and it's not going to interfere in a major chord quite as much. So one way to play major chords on bells and minimize the clashing of overtones is simply to play those major chords on higher bells, smaller bells. But this alone is not a very satisfying answer, because it's those low bells, those bass bells, that make a tower instrument so impressive, rich, resonant, and satisfying. Sure, sometimes playing only high bells works, but I'd lose my job if at the next graduation ceremony with 10,000 people outside, I played a full hour of music only up on the treble bells. That sound just doesn't carry as well. So we need another trick, a way to play major chords on bass bells. And that leads us to voicing, both vertical voicing and horizontal voicing. Vertically, we're talking about where exactly to place each note within a chord. You might be familiar with inversions, where you rearrange the notes in different orders. So which inversion should we use? Well, our goal is really to separate the minor third overtone from the major third that we're playing. So in the C major chord, we're hearing a minor third E flat present in the C bell. There's no getting around that. We can't get rid of it. So if we're going to play an E natural at the same time, let's take the inversion that places the C further away from the E. That inversion sounds a little bit less dissonant than the others, but we could put even more vertical space between those two notes. And let's face it, we usually do want the chord in root position with a C on the bottom. So let's go back to root position and take the E up a whole octave. There, taking that third up an octave is perhaps the simplest and one of the most effective ways to make this major chord sound a bit more major. I'm not saying it's perfect, but it is a lot better. And look, here's something really cool. That major third up an octave, a major tenth, that major tenth is actually present in the frequency spectrum of the low C bell. Look, in that one bell, we have the hum tone, the prime, the minor third, but if we keep going, we get a fifth, a G, an octave, another C, and then we get a major tenth in E natural. that major 10th isn't always there in every bell, and the overtone isn't usually tuned directly by the bell founder, but we can often find that major 10th in a well-tuned bell. Now, there's also often an 11th, as there is in this bell, as well as many higher overtones. And all these higher overtones, including the major 10th, will dissipate a lot faster than the minor third overtone that's really dominant. But for all the fuss I make about bells sounding minor and out of tune, there is something inherently major in each bell too. So if we play a passage in tenths, I like to think we're inherently amplifying that major 10th in the bell. A lot of composers use tenths, and playing in tenths is a great trick, and it's not hard to do when playing off a lead sheet or improvising or composing or arranging. So if I'm playing Bach, I've got my melody and my tenor, and I can keep my bass bells a whole octave below, where the minor third overtones are going to clash quite a bit less. Playing melodies up an octave from the bass is actually in direct contrast with some advice I've given before, which is to flip the arrangements and put melodies on the bottom and harmonies on top. And this just goes to show that different tricks are going to work better in different situations. So here's another trick. In addition to thinking about vertical voicing, we can look at the horizontal voicing, the space and time between each note. Look, even that worst example of a C major triad and root position on the bass bells will sound a little bit better if I make it into an arpeggio, because I'm separating the E flat overtone and the E natural bell with a little bit of time. Arpeggios work really well in the high bells too, not just because the major and minor thirds are clashing less, but arpeggios just sound really nice on bells. And there are many more ways to write horizontally than simply arpeggiating chords. Actually, one really common technique is to play a bass bell and then have the musical phrase follow. I do this a lot in my own writing. So there we go. While minor chords will sound more in tune than major chords on bells, we still can play songs in a major key. And we should, because if we only play songs in minor keys or octatonic keys, then we're not approaching the instrument with the versatility that it demands of us.